on. And I'm giving you a bit of a clue because I'm in the garden and it's all about flowers. So what I want you to do is to look at the flowers and see if you can name them. But if you can't name them, you can just tell me the colour. It might be red. I don't know. And now I've got my five answers. I hope you enjoyed my quiz. So the answer to number one was a red rose. Number two was a yellow sunflower. Three was bluebells. Number four was yellow daffodil. Number five was a white rose. Round two is with Pete, and I'll give you a clue. He likes cooking.
Hi everyone, it's Pete here. Time for today's quiz, all about food. So, are we ready? Question one is, if I was making a sandwich, it was called a BLT, what would be inside? So if I made you a sandwich and it was called a BLT, what would be inside? Question two, what's this? What is this? Some type of food. What do you think this is? What's the name of this? Question three. What types of food are pita, naan, and baguettes? So what food are pita, naan, and baguettes? Question number four. Can you name three red fruits? So can you name three red fruits? Last question, question number five. What sweet food is made from bees? So, what sweet food is made from bees? If you pause the video now, and I'll come back with the answers in just a moment. So, ready? 3, 2, 1, pause. Hello again. We're ready with these answers. So, question one, if I was going to make a sandwich and it was a BLT, what's inside? Bacon, lettuce, and a tomato. B for bacon, L for lettuce, and a T for tomato. So question number two, what was that? Can you remember? What was that? What type of food? That's an avocado. bit soft. Question number three. So I said, what types of food are pita, naan, and baguettes? Well, they're all different types of bread. Did you get that one right? Right, next one. I said, can you name three red fruits? I've got some here. I've got a few strawberries from the garden. I could have said raspberries or cherries or apples. Grapes. All different ones. How many did you get? Last question. So the last question was, what sweet food is made from bees? Honey. Sticky honey. Right, I wonder how many you got right out of those five. Let us know. See you soon. Take care. Hi everyone, it's Pete here. Time for today's quiz, all about food. So, are we ready? Question one is, if I was making a sandwich, it was called a BLT, what would be inside? So if I made you a sandwich and it was called a BLT, what would be inside? Question two. What's this? What is this? Some type of food. What do you think this is? What's the name of this? Question three. What types of food are pita, naan, and baguettes? So what food are pita, naan, and baguettes? Question number four. Can you name three red fruits? So can you name three red fruits? Last question, question number five. What sweet food is made from bees? So what sweet food is made from bees? If you pause the video now, and I'll come back with the answers in just a moment. So ready? 3, 2, 1, pause. Hello again. We're ready with these answers. So, question one, if I was gonna make a sandwich and it was a BLT, what's inside? Bacon. Lettuce. And a tomato. B for bacon, L for lettuce, and a T for tomato. So question number two. What was that? Can you remember? What was that? What type of food? That's an avocado. A bit soft. Question number three. So I said, what types of food are pita, naan, and baguettes? Well, they're all different types of bread. Did you get that one right? Right, next one. I said, can you name three red fruits? I've got some here. I've got a few strawberries from the garden. I could have said raspberries or cherries or apples. Grapes. All different ones. How many did you get? Last question. So the last question was, what sweet food is made from bees? Honey. Sticky honey. Right, I wonder how many you got right out of those five. Let us know. See you soon. Take care.
Everyone, so it's my turn now for the next round, and we are going to do a sports round. So, question number one. What sport do you use this in? Okay, so what sport do you use this in? Okay. Question number two. What sport would you use this in? What sport would you use this in? Okay. Question number three. What sport would you use these? What sport would you use these? Question number four is, what sport would you use these in? What sport would you use these in? Okay. And question number five. What place would you go and watch all of these? Alright. Okay. So, right, time for the answers. So, question one was, what sport would you use this in? It is, of course, a football. So you'd use it in football. Question number two was, what sport would you use this in? This is, of course, a rugby ball. So you'd use it in rugby. And question number three, what sport would you use these in? They are, of course, goggles. And you would use them swimming. And question number four, what sport would you use these in? This is a tennis racket and a tennis ball. You use it in tennis. And question number five was, what was the name of the place where you go and see all of these? And that is a stadium. So hopefully you got all of those right. Bye.
Hello everyone, my name's Marie. Thank you to Grant for his round of the quiz, that was really good. Now my round of the quiz is all about transport. Okay, so question one. What transport would you use to cross the sea? So question one. What transport would you use to cross the sea? Okay, question two. What transport carries lots of passengers, has two floors, and we sing a song where we say the wheels go round and round? So question two. What transport carries lots of passengers, has two floors, and we sing a song that says the wheels go round and round? Have a think. So question three, what transport do people use to go abroad on holiday overseas? You get on it at an airport. Okay, so question three, what transport do you use to go abroad on holiday and you get on at an airport? So question four, what transport travels on tracks? Straight tracks. Okay, so question number four. What transport travels on tracks? Okay, last question, question five. What transport speeds through the streets and firemen use to get to put out a fire? Oh, that's too easy, really. So question five. What transport speeds through the streets and firemen use it to put out a fire? Okay, so if you want to pause the video and I'll come back with the answers. Okay, so pause in 3, 2, 1. Okay, welcome back. So we need the answers to my transport quiz. So question one, was what transport would you use to cross the sea? Okay, it's a boat. Yeah, did you get that one? Now question two, what transport carries lots of passengers, has two floors, and we sing the wheels go round and round? Did you get that? Yeah, it's a bus. Yeah, just like this one, Devon General Bus. Now question three, what transport do people use to go abroad overseas when you get on at an airport? Yes, it's an aeroplane. Maybe it's an easy jet like this one. Right, now question four, what transport travels on tracks? Yeah. I've got train. Well, you could have had a tram, but train's the answer, I know. And question five, what transport speeds through the streets and firemen use it to put out a fire? Yes, it's a fire engine. And this one. This one's at Newton Abbot, just like me. Right, there we go, it's the end of my quiz.
Hi everyone, Becky here. So it's my turn for this round. Just want to say thanks to Marie for her round. That was great fun. Okay, so my round is about Disney. So let's see what you know about that. Okay, question number one. What type of fish is Nemo? Do you know? What type of fish is Nemo? Question number two. What is the princess called in Aladdin? What's her name? Does anybody know? What's the princess called in Aladdin? Question number three. Where does Anna and Elsa live? Do you know where they live? What's it called? Do you know? Question number four. In Winnie the Pooh, what type of animal is Eeyore? Now there's lots of animals in Winnie the Pooh, but what type of animal is Eeyore? Tricky one. Question number five, my last question. Who do the toys belong to in Toy Story? I'll give you a hint. If you look on their foot, you might just find a name. Who do the toys belong to in Toy Story? Okay, if you want to pause it, you can. Try and find the answers. Ready to pause? In 3, 2, 1. Hi, it's me again. Okay, the answers to my Disney round. What type of fish is Nemo? Nemo is a clownfish. It's a funny name for a fish, clownfish. Question two. What was the princess in Aladdin called? Her name is Jasmine. Princess Jasmine. She has a pet tiger. It's a bit scary. Three. Where does Anna and Elsa live? They live in Arendelle. Could be a bit cold there, can't it, when Elsa makes it snow. It'd be fun to have a snowman though, wouldn't it, all the time? Question number four. In Winnie the Pooh, Eeyore is a donkey. There we go, and his tail comes off, doesn't it? And my last question, question number five. Who do the toys belong to in Toy Story? They belong to Andy. There we go. Hope you've enjoyed my round. And I'll see you all soon. Bye!
Hi everyone, it's Susie here and my round's all about music. So we need to do some really good listening because I'm going to play some tracks for you and you've got to try and think of what the song is. Okay, you ready? Number one.
Okay. I see what's happening, yeah. Face to face with greatness and it's strange. You don't even know how you feel. It's adorable. Well, it's nice to see that humans never change.
Okay, right, so you ready for number two?
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. So Josh is here, you can take a break.
Okay. Wonder what song that was. Number three, are you ready? Okay, so it's time for number four. That one was an easy one. Everyone should get that one. And number five. Okay, so they're my five songs. So I'm going to pause the video and I'm going to let you know the answers. Are you ready? One, two, three, pause. So everyone, it's time for the answers. So how did you all get on? So number one was this song. Right, I'm gonna speed it up. That song was from Moana and it was called You're Welcome. Okay, so answer number two. So that song was Happy from Despicable Me. We've watched the film by Pharrell Williams. Okay, so answer number three. I got this feeling inside my bones. Okay, that song was called Can't Stop the Feeling and that was in the Trolls film by Justin Timberlake. And number four. Oh, sorry, number four. Everyone should know this one. That song was Baby Shark. Okay, so ready for answer number five. Okay, so that answer, it was Shake It Off by Taylor Swift. How did you get on, everybody? Bye.
Okay, thank you, Susie. Hi, everyone. It's Catherine here. So my round of quiz questions are about TV programs. Let's see how you're doing. So question number one. What breed of dog is Chase in Paw Patrol? I know a lot of you are fans of Paw Patrol. So there's a lot of different breeds of dogs in there. Question number two, in Peppa Pig, what's the name of Edmund the elephant's sister? So Edmund's sister, what's her name? I'll give you a clue. She does wear a yellow dress. That should make it easier. Question number three, what island is Thomas and friends set on? Okay, question number four. What's the name of Wallace's dog in the Adam animations? Should be easy, that one. It's Wallace and... Okay, and question number five. Who is Bart Simpson's dad? Bart Simpson's dad. Do you know? Have a think. Okay, time to pause now and I'll see you later. Bye. Hello everyone, I'm back. Here are the answers of the quiz question. So the question number one was what type or what breed of dog is Chase in Paw Patrol? So the answer is it's a German Shepherd. Okay, question number two about Peppa Pig. What is the name of Edmund the elephant's sister? So Edmund's sister's name is Emily. Okay, hope you've got that right. Question number three. What was the name of the island on which Thomas and friends takes place? So it's the island of Sodor. Well done if you've got that right. Question number four. What was the name of Wallace's dog in the Adam animation, so it's Wallace and Gromit. Well done, if you've got that right. And finally, question number 5. What's the names of Bart Simpson's dad? Bart Simpson's dad is called Homer. Okay, I hope you've got them all right, and I'll see you soon. Bye.
Hello Holly Lane, it's Caroline from the Sibling Group. I'm doing an animal round, so here's my first question. What are baby swans called? Can you see them there swimming with their mum? What are baby swans called? Okay, question number 2. Here is a chicken. The girl chickens are called hens, but what is a boy chicken called? Can I give you a clue? They do this noise, cock-a-doodle-doo. So what is a boy chicken called? Question number 3. This is an ostrich. It's a very, very big bird. This is an ostrich. Can you see? It's got really big feathers. He's coming to say hello. My question is, can ostriches fly? Can ostriches fly? Question number 4. What is the name for a baby goat? Here's a goat. Here comes one. Oh, hello. Oh. So what is the name for a baby goat? Question number 5. Here's a horse having a nibble on some grass. My question is, at the bottom of their feet, what do they have? What is the name of the things that are at the bottom of their feet? It's a bit like nails. Okay, that was the questions for the animal round. If you want to have a pause of the video to have a think, now's your chance to do that. Here are the answers. So the first question was about a baby swan. What is the name of a baby swan? The answer is a cygnet. Did you get that? A cygnet is a baby swan. Number 2. With a boy chicken, what is it called? It's called a cockerel. It's called a cockerel and it makes the noise cock-a-doodle-doo. Number 3. An ostrich. A big bird that's called an ostrich. Can they fly? No, they can't fly. Question number 4. A baby goat. What is the name of a baby goat? It's a kid. It's called a kid. And the last question was about the horse, about at the end of the horse's feet. What is it called? And it's slightly like your fingernails. It's called hooves. Did you get them right? Well done. Bye-bye.
Hi everyone, it's Luke. This is my round for the quiz, and this is the final round. This round is going to be general knowledge. So question number 1. What is the capital city of England? What is the capital city of England? Question number 2. Who lives in a pineapple under the sea? Who lives in a pineapple under the sea? I'll give you a clue. This is a cartoon. Question number 3. Finish this line from the song in Frozen. Let it what? Let it what? Question number 4. What is the Gruffalo's favourite food? What is the Gruffalo's favourite food? So in the story he says this is his favourite food. But what is it? And question number 5. What planet do we live on? What planet do we live on? If you're still trying to get the answers, then just pause the video now. because then I'm going to now read out the answers in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now. Okay, so the answer to number one, what is the capital city of England? And the answer is London. The answer to number two, who lives in a pineapple under the sea? SpongeBob SquarePants. Question number three was, finish this line of a song from Frozen. Let it go. Question number four was, what is the Gruffalo's favourite food? And that is roasted fox. And number five, what planet do we live on? And that is planet Earth. I hope you enjoyed this really, really fun quiz that we've all done. If you want to write down what score you got, it doesn't matter if you got lots, it doesn't matter if you didn't get any at all. It's just for a bit of fun. Hope you're enjoying your summer break, and I'll see you soon. Bye.